I'm being handed here a can of Bud Light because, you know, it is 5 o'clock somewhere. It's like what I like to say on this show. This is not the new souped up Bud Light, I believe. There's a Bud Light Platinum that's on the supermarket shelves, higher alcohol content. What's behind this brand, Anheuser-Busch?
Yeah, it's in supermarkets and it's also at bars. A little over three years ago, InBev from Belgium bought Anheuser-Busch, became the biggest brewer in the U.S. They've done a really good job of boosting the operating profit. It's gone above 40% from less than 30%. One thing they're still trying to figure out is how to get more Americans to be buying their beers. And so they've actually had falling volumes now for 3 years. This year they're launching a bunch of new products. One of them is this Bud Light Platinum. And it's got 6% alcohol content. Comes in a very pretty blue bottle. And it's designed to try and win back some market share from a lot of people who've moved on to either, you know, craft beers or in many cases, liquor.
I was trying to find out how much alcohol content was in this regular can of Bud Light. I'm not sure. It's very fine print.
4.2%.
4.2%. See, you know that. You've been all over this story, in fact, for Anheuser-Busch, talking about how really in the beer market, all of the beer makers are having to sort of sex up what they're making to keep up with the liquor companies. What else have they got up their sleeve?
Well, a lot of them are, you know, launching products that don't have a lot to do with beer. And Anheuser-Busch is a good example. They're coming out with a Bud Light Limerita, which I tried in St. Louis last week, and it tastes like a margarita. There's no tequila in it. That is about 8%. They've also got some, you know, lower alcohol content stuff. They've got a Michelob, one of their beer brands, is coming out in the coming weeks with a cider, a light cider. And they're also coming out with light tea and lemonade. So basically they're trying to expand their repertoire. And this is, you know, after a lot of the spirits companies have been pretty aggressive in innovation, creating stuff like, you know, marshmallow flavored vodka and such.
And also with the packaging, it looks like, I mean, those blue bottles, clearly meant to the Platinum, the Bud Light Platinum, clearly meant to stand out in a bar. Mike, I do have to wonder though, for people who are true beer aficionados, for people who just like to drink their Bud, you know, what's the risk of backlash from people just thinking this is awfully silly?
Well, I mean, they can, you know, they can keep buying that, and certainly and the company's not backing away from traditional Bud Light or from Budweiser. It's still the number one, the number three most sold beers in the U.S. They're hiking up their marketing. You know, they signed for Bud Light, is now the official sponsor, official beer of the NFL. It's a 6-year deal. I think it cost them over $1 billion. And likewise for Budweiser, they've been very aggressive in terms of marketing. They have a lot of sponsorships. They got the Clydesdales out, you know, the pull horses, evoking scenes in some of their commercials back to 1933. When Budweiser was much more popular. Budweiser has fallen 23 straight years now in the U.S. in volume. So that's a problem that that the Belgian company inherited.
Now, I think you can't get enough of those Clydesdales. Every time I see them on the screen, I cannot help but smile. I also wonder what they're doing in terms of their wholesalers, Mike. I think there's been some talk of them putting pressure on those wholesalers. What do you know?
Yeah, that's a developing story. And it's not the first time, even under the previous ownership, the U.S. ownership, Anheuser-Busch, you know, used to try to strong arm the distributors. In the U.S., you can't sell beer directly to retailers. You go through an intermediary, through a wholesaler. And there's hundreds of these across the country. Anheuser-Busch has more than 500 that they use. And basically what they've been telling them in recent months is, you know, stop selling, filling your trucks with all this craft beer from other rival brews. Most of your business comes from us. And if you, you know, basically, if you want to keep it and if you want to grow with us, pay more attention to us.